I was in the office when I got an email about a dog that had wandered into this woman's driveway. And she had sent a picture, and it is obvious the dog is in horrible shape.
No hair, it just kind of like showed up in this woman's driveway, but we should definitely go now just because it looks like it doesn't feel very well.
I went outside to find Elise to see if she could help me get this dog.
She said that the dog went up onto her porch. The poor thing just like wants somebody probably.
The email had said that the dog seemed injured and wasn't able to walk on its back leg.
I'll show you a picture when we get in the car.
There's no way for us to know what type of internal injuries the dog could possibly have, so we need to get this dog as quick as possible.
It's really sad. He's so skinny.
That's the dog.
Aww.
So that's why we kind of have to hurry. Judging by the picture, the dog is in really horrible condition, so we need to get this dog as quick as possible.
She says that he's like walking pretty slow, so it does sound like he doesn't feel very well.
I'm just hoping that this dog will let us, you know, get him some help, and he's not too afraid of us and doesn't act out aggressively.
Here we go.
The dog wasn't in the driveway anymore, and so I'm thinking, okay, that's odd.
All right, let's go check it out. Oh my God. Hi, honey. Oh, she sees us. Oh my God, he really is. Hi.
Oh my God, that is the saddest thing I've ever seen.
Oh my God.
Little bug.
Hi, baby.
Oh my God.
We can tell on the outside that the dog's in horrible shape. You know, it doesn't have any hair. I'm just hoping that this dog will let us easily load him up into a crate.
Hi, sweet baby. Hi, baby. Do you want to come say hi? You're okay. Come here. Come here. Are you too sick? Or are you just scared? You want to go for a walk?
You went to Salmon's? You might like the Sam's.
There you go.
Good.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God. Look at his skin.
I know. Wow. Horrible shape. Hi, honey.
With a dog like this, we just basically need to get the dog and get it to the vet as quickly as possible so they can assess the extent of the dog's injuries. I'm not even sure if he can actually move anymore at this point.
Yeah, he seems pretty weak. Okay, all right, not yet, we'll wait.
Let me bring the crate over.
We'll put some treats in it. Oh, poor thing. Okay, honey, it's okay. Oh, he's got like a sore on the side. Oh, my baby, it's okay. Sweet baby, can you stand? Do you wanna go bye-bye? Can you try?
He tried standing up, and it was really, really difficult on him. And then I could finally see how badly his leg was injured, and he would not put it down. He would not put any weight on it.
Good job.
Hi. And he just looks really broken down emotionally. You know, he looks very defeated and sad.
I think he's, like, gonna go. I think he just needs a second. Yeah, here he goes.
So sad.
There he goes. Oh, okay, I'm just gonna leave the leash on.
This dog has clearly had a horrible life. A dog doesn't get like this overnight.
Hey, buddy.
This takes time, losing all of that hair. This dog has been abandoned and on his own for a while, and that in itself is heartbreaking.
You don't have to live like that anymore.
I'm really relieved that we have this dog, and now we can get him the medical care that he needs. We took him immediately to the emergency vet, and he did have to stay for a couple of days for testing on his skin and his injured leg. And he is finally ready to be picked up. How are you?
Doing all right.
We are here to pick up Salmon.
You went to Salmon's?
There you go.
We decided to name the dog Salmon because we had brought treats with us, and the treats were salmon flavored, and he seemed to love those the most. So it just seemed like it fit.
Hey.
hey, y'all can head on in.
Hi.
Hey. He could have a lot of medical problems, and, you know, whenever a dog comes in that has a lot of medical needs, it takes a really long time to get them ready for a home.
Here comes Salmon. Come on in, come on, sweetheart.
Oh my God. Hi, you're so cute. Oh my God, isn't he so cute?
So his skin is pretty badly infected. He's got bacteria on his skin. He's also got a yeast infection too. So we're doing antibiotics and antifungal. But he also, one of the reasons that he looks so naked and so scabby is because he has Demodex. And that's just a little mite that lives in the skin. And so we're definitely already treating him.
So the first time seeing Salmon, he definitely looks like a baby that's been neglected and spent a good time probably outside and lost.
Because he has so much significant damage, I don't know that all of this is gonna come back. So he might still have kind of like weird patchy hair.
This is definitely a chronic infection to the point where his skin has thickened over time, but we could treat for that.
Pit bulls like to scar so easily. I don't know exactly how much
he'll look. Gonna have.
Yeah, he may be naked forever, I'm not sure.
It's gonna take him a while to grow that hair back, and it's definitely gonna take us a longer time to get over the skin just because it is such a deep infection, but we'll just see how he heals.
With his leg, what do you think that is?
It's an injury, more than likely just either muscles or ligaments.
Mm-hmm.
But I did take some x-rays of it. His bones are all in the right place. We don't have any breaks, so it's nothing serious. But it is something that if y'all could work with him, like rehabbing, trying to get him to use that leg more often, I think that would make a difference too. He's a very sweet dog. He's got a great disposition. So I do think that y'all will, oh, he's so sweet. I think that y'all will find him a home pretty quickly.
I would say long-term, his prognosis is pretty good. As long as we can get over the skin infection, we can certainly fix his knee, we can neuter him. He's heartworm negative. I think he's got a good outlook.
Good boy.
I have a lot of hope for this dog. He still is in bad shape, but he's on the road to recovery, and the silver lining in this is that he is not heartworm positive, and he is really sweet. Look at him, look how cute he is. You know, once he gets his hair back and his leg is healed, we're gonna find him a great home.
Salmon filet.
Bully him, he's naked. He's already vulnerable.
He's just a little nude.
Salmon's been back from the vet for about a week now, and he is already improving.
Oh, wow.
That
was very generous.
Yeah, you were. Very liberal. Okay. Salmon is not limping anymore, so his leg seems to have healed pretty nicely. And as far as his hair goes, that's gonna take a while. The vet did explain that there may be some areas where his hair doesn't completely grow back.
Hopefully this will get rid of some of this like nasty, like calloused areas and just start to treat the skin so that way we can get some regrowth.
Some more hair.
Yeah.
So he won't be naked forever. So this dog is gonna be a project. It's gonna take some time and some effort to get him healthy and looking good. And the leg is definitely gonna require some rehab and some exercises that Heidi will do with him.
No, why are you shivering? Don't shiver.
I mean, it's totally worth it. And it's nice that he's really sweet and his personality is starting to come out. You know, it gives me a lot of hope for him. We've seen a lot of ACL tears. I feel like sometimes they take forever to heal. Don't you think that was quick?
Oh yeah, and also just more often than not, it seems like when you bring in a dog for an ACL injury, it's like surgery is pretty much recommended. It's so rare that like we get a partial tear where we can actually get the option to crate rest them and help them recover that way.
I mean, it's like you wouldn't know, like looking at him right now, you wouldn't even know that he had a tear the way he's walking. It's so crazy. Every dog deserves a chance at a home. No matter what type of condition they're in, when we find them, we try everything. You know, whether they're on the brink of death or in Salmon shape, we do it all to get them healthy again. They don't deserve anything less than that.
Yeah, he did pretty good.
It's pretty good, buddy. He's not neutered, but that's a really easy fix.
I'm a little nude.
Next for Salmon is getting him settled at the rescue and just basically helping him heal from the inside out and getting him ready for a home.